shot man Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that lonesome whistle, I hit my head in. I don't know, I haven't written that many songs.
Maybe you have a strong moral objection. to wizards and all this. Okay, fine. Don't look at it. I didn't tell you to go worship Satan.
And what good will your cursing do? You stand around, you curse, and you chatter, and you don't do anything.
The doorknob to the cabinet is broken. The wood glue can't be found. Every other day I don't know what to do. I want to avoid everyone I run into. But a box of cream of wheat has left me wondering how I'm gonna open up that door. I tried messing around, pulling from the corners out, but it just won't budge. I guess I'll turn off the burner to the pot I was warm in the milk in.
Plans now being laid to throw the United States into a third world war.
End of message.
The noble Brutus hath told you Caesar was ambitious. If it was so, it was a grievous fault, and grievously hath Caesar answered it. Here under leave of Brutus and the rest, for Brutus is an honorable man. So are they all honorable men. Come I to speak in Caesar's funeral. He was my friend, faithful and just to me. But Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. He hath brought many captives home to Rome, whose ransoms did the general coffers fill. Did this in Caesar seem ambitious? When did the poor have cried, Caesar hath wept? Ambition should be made of sterner stuff. Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. You all did see that on the Lupercal I thrice presented him a kingly crown, which he did thrice refuse. Was this ambition? Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and sure he is an honorable man. I speak not to disprove what Brutus spoke, but here I am to speak what I do know. You all did love him once, not without cause. What cause withholds you then to mourn for him? O judgment, thou art led to brutish beasts, and men have lost their reason.
Something's wrong, folks, in America. Something's really wrong.
Let truth be scared. I'm not prepared.
Throne of the toilet is where y'all are. The throne of the toilet is what Glenn Beck sits on. The throne of the toilet is what that weasel, Sarah Palin, the throne of the toilet is what Rushler, you're sitting on the throne of the toilet. And you're cleaning yourself and absolving yourselves with the Constitution and the Bible. I ain't gonna never let y'all forget this.
There's a banana tree at the end of the
tree. Aliens in the universe that are more malevolent, and they are at war with these things because that is where this sound came from. And I feel that if I can instigate conflict and increase conflict between these aliens, that they will get warring between themselves, and if I can damage the Greys enough, that they will cease to exist, and we'll be rid of these things and maybe be allowed to continue. And maybe in that continuance we can demonstrate to the more benevolent ones that we are more than just cattle to feed on and to be exploited, and maybe one day we can paddle off this island Earth and be acceptable in larger areas.
As if you could get ready for the end of the world. You can't get ready for that. What the hell's the matter with you?